94.5, Balthazar Pellas. Yes, we got LL Cool J tickets on the way. Yes, we got a jam scam in minutes. Keep it locked in. It's 6:03 right now. Are you ready for today's fat clip? Here it comes.
I don't believe this. Barbara Streisand? But this is my bachelor party, and I am not going to what? Pardon my split infinitive. Funny girl.
Me neither. I hate that crap.
Oh, I gotta see that. Is that on video?
What?
That's not on video. We gotta see that movie. Oh my god. If Balthazar Pebbles hanging out. Is it gonna be 70 today, Pebbles?
75.
75. Can you believe it? A day finally with sunshine. What you people don't know out there in Radio Land is that today is the second day without Curtis Martin for Pebbles.
Oh, here you go. Why do you have to start this again?
Yesterday we had a long discussion about this. If you missed it, my conspiracy theories are alive and well. I believe Miss Braxton has told Curtis, I don't like Attleboro. Well, guess what? We don't like you, and now you're a Jet fan, Curtis Martin.
Ah! Hello, this is Curtis Martin, calling in the 94.5. Wish everybody a happy holiday. Hey, what's up?
I'm not hearing you, Curtis.
It's time to grow up, Curtis. I don't leave Curtis alone.
We're going to talk about this right now. Jammin' 94.5.
I wanna do, wanna be ballers, shot callers, brawlers, who be dipping in the bins with the spoilers, on the low from the Jake and the Taurus, trying to get my hands on some grants like Horace, yeah, living the raw deal, three course meal, spaghetti, fettuccine, and veal, but
it's all about the Benjamins, baby, yeah. It's all about the Benjamins, baby.
Jammin' 94.5, I'm sorry, but that's the Curtis Martin theme song right there, all about the Benjis, the Curtis.
Mm-mm.
What's the matter, Pebbles?
Leave that man alone.
Here comes your movie clip.
I don't believe this. Barbara Streisand? But this is my bachelor party, and I am not going to what? Pardon my split infinitive. Funny girl.
Me neither. I hate that crap.
I heard that's a funny movie. What's that fat clip?
In and out.
In and out. It sounds so kinky.
Am I right?
Who's this?
It's Flava.
Hey.
Flava.
Where are you?
Balthazar and Pebbles.
Hey, you're hyped up, baby. The weekend's here.
Listen, I have been up since 10 o'clock last night. Of course I'm hyped up.
You got spring fever. It's going to be 75 today. Can you believe that?
I'm taking my iguana out for a walk today.
You get an iguana?
Yeah.
Well, you go check us out. You and your iguana. What's his name?
Lightfoot.
We got that movie In and Out starring Kevin Klein, courtesy of Paramount Home Video.
All right.
And also available this weekend. Pick it up at Nat Video locations. You're good to go, Flava.
All right.
I'm glad somebody's happy over there.
I know, really.
I'd be happy if the wind blew.
We're living our second day without Curtis Martin over here.
Oh God.
I don't know how I'm gonna deal with this.
I feel bad for Pebbles.
I'm fine. He's actually blowing this up.
Flava, don't you think Toni Braxton had a lot to do with this?
It's all her fault, man. That's what I was just
saying
the other day.
And so what if she did?
If that's her fault.
His woman.
See how Pebbles gets? A little bit.
No, that's so stupid.
Hang on.
If it was broke, you'd do it too.
Flava, what do you think? Conspiracy theory. Give me a conspiracy theory. What happened? Why is Curtis Martin leaving?
Why is he leaving?
Yeah.
I believe because there are no Gucci outlets out there in Attleboro. That's why I believe it.
Thank you.
Oh, my goodness.
No Gucci outlets. I like that theory. Hang on. Let me see. Okay, I like that theory. No Gucci outlets in Attleboro. That's where Curtis...
You are so wrong.
That's where what's-her-name was rumored to have a house with Curtis Martin. No.
Not with.
I can just imagine Toni Braxton coming into town and finding out there's no Gucci outlets out here.
Yeah!
All right, conspiracy theories run rampant. Why did Curtis leave us? I have another theory.
I don't think I want to hear it.
You're going to hear that in 15 minutes. This conspiracy theory actually makes a lot of sense. You get yours in at 931-1945. LL Cool J tickets. When you hear lounging, just be caller 25. We got tickets coming up. Jam Scam and a whole lot more. It's a Fat Friday right here on Jammin'.
Listen to Jammin' 94.5 all this week to win tickets to see LL Cool J and Lowell. Ladies love Cool J at Super Jam 97. Now, Jammin' 94.5's got your tickets to see him for the first time since he rocked the house at the Fleet Center. To win.
Make sure you keep your FM locked to your free concert frequency. Jammin' 94.5.
Okay. Free food. All you gotta do is apply the Kelly's Roast Beef and Natick.
All
right. Anytime, Monday through Saturday, 10 a.m. to 7 p.m.
There's my new job.
Jammin' 94.5 at 6:23. This is Pebbles, and this traffic report's brought to you by Brothers Gourmet Coffee. Downtown, the Tobin and the Sumner both look good. Lower decks out to Community College. Northbound Expressway, a little busy by Granite Avenue from Savin Hill to Andrew. Route 3 North is slow at Union Street, and we have reports of an accident at the Mass Pike eastbound between Newton Corner and the Austin Tolls. Fog Lifter Supreme Roast Coffee from Brothers Gourmet. It's enough to make you think twice about hitting the snooze button. Fog Lifter by Brothers, how was your morning? Sunny today, high of 75. Right now it's 53 degrees. You're listening to LL Cool J Lounging to win your tickets to see LL.
All right, 6:23, Baltazar and Pebbles getting with the flow in about 10 minutes. Flo Anthony joins us. We're going to find out who Grant Hill is heading towards lockdown with. Who ticked off Madonna backstage at the Academy Awards? And you're wondering about this. Who's the next Calvin Klein underwear man? In minutes on Jammin'.
Every night in my dreams, I see you.
This is Jerry Springer.
Hey, Pebbles, close your eyes. I'm naked, Baltazar. What you gonna do?
I'm Jammin' 94.5.
Four, five, 6:31. Don't forget LL Cool J tickets when you hear Loungin' guaranteed before 8. And get with the flow next after next.
Yeah.
Does that make sense?
Come on, no.
Too close. Jamming.
Uh oh, you feel that? All right. Come on. Don't stop now. You done did it. Come on. Yeah. All right. Hold up.
Four, five, both Baltazar and Pebbles waking you up on a Friday, March 27th, 1998, the first day of summer. It's going to be 75 today.
Yeah.
Yeah. First day of... Shut up, Mel. Play along with it, Mel. Play along with it. This is radio. Check it out. Your jam schedule at 7:30. Also, LL Cool J tickets with Loungin'. That's guaranteed before 8 o'clock. And we'll get to more Curtis Martin conspiracy theories.
Oh, here you go.
It's a sad day, Pebbles. Not only because Curtis Martin's leaving, but a couple of our fellow fans here who just dropped by the station out of the blue. And I get on the microphone and say hello. These guys are the cutest guys. Who we got here?
Hello.
That's Chandler.
Hi.
And that's Christian.
All right. You guys are moving to Arizona, but you guys grew up listening to Jammin', and your mom's over here with the camera.
Hi, Mom.
Paparazzi's in the house.
Oh, that's
well,
right.
We wish you the best of luck, all right?
Thank you.
You guys are sweet. This little man right here.
He wants your job. He was sitting in your seat when you left the studio, so you better watch it.
Yeah, I'll get you on the air, man. Don't worry about that. 6:35, this lady, which is about Flo Anthony, has been doing a great job backstage at the Academy Awards. Time to get with the Flo. Where are you today, Flo?
I'm finally home, Baltazar. Praise the Lord.
Academy Awards are finally done. You got a lot of fun, though, doing those things, right?
Yeah, you know what? A lot of it's fun. Things like the Oscars are a lot of fun.
Who's going to be making big money right after the Academy Awards?
I think that Kim Basinger will start to get big money because she doesn't get money like Demi Moore and Julia Roberts and them get.
I was telling Pebbles this. I believe Kim Basinger's on the Toni Braxton dingy side. What do you think?
She's a real dingy because let me tell you something. That Escada dress that she actually ended up wearing to the Oscars, she put on 2 hours, she decided, before she went. I mean, it was ridiculous. Only a crazy person would have done that.
I heard Matt Damon is the next Calvin Klein guy.
Yeah, you know what, and Prada was also chasing him.
Prada?
Yes, Prada was chasing him also, and at first he turned them both down, but he yelled it out when he got his Oscar.
See, I think that Matt Damon and Ben Affleck should do everything together.
Yeah, Russ.
Because I think they're so much better as a team.
People are going to start talking about them, you know what I'm saying?
I mean, people already are.
They are? What are people saying about...
I'm just teasing.
No, I'm just saying.
Something happened between them and Madonna backstage.
What happened?
Well, you know what? She was really angry when she came out there. And I, like you said, I thought something happened with Jim and Hanji.
Yeah, the guy from Amistad turned it down.
Yeah, but I understand that she had some kind of weird exchange with them, and that's why...